from the USA. She is associate director of the reproduction and childhood and doctor for the U at Mumbai. And she is going to talk on the how gynecologists can transfer the breastfeeding scene from the antenatal training to breast growth. Madam, please stick with the time of the 50 limit. Thank you, ma'am.
I hope you can see my presentation.
Yes.
I'll try to finish in time. I have been given 15 minutes, although this is a long topic, but try to finish in time. Thanks a lot for this opportunity to speak in front of all of you. As a gynecologist, I think this is a very relevant topic to share. How gynecs can transform the breastfeeding scene. So normally, when we talk about breastfeeding, ki baat karte hai, we always talk about neonatologists or pediatricians. Hai na? So we usually don't involve gynecologists in breastfeeding. And today I'm speaking about how gynecs can work on this. So India is traditionally known as a breastfeeding country. Hamare ghar mein kahin na kahin hamesha ek कृष्ण और यशोदा की फोटोग्राफ होती है ब्रेस्टफीडिंग की. हमारे घर में कोई ना कोई हमेशा ब्रेस्टफीडिंग के लिए आया होता है, मौसी चाची. बट एंड आल्सो साइंस इज प्रूवन बियॉन्ड डाउट व्हाई ब्रेस्टफीडिंग इज इम्पोर्टेंट. ब्रेस्टफीडिंग विद इन वन आवर ऑफ बर्थ कैन डिक्रीज नियोनेटल मोर्टेलिटी बाय 22%. दैट इज अ ह्यूज नंबर फॉर अ प्लेस लाइक इंडिया. बट स्टिल लुक एट दी स्टैटिस्टिक्स ऑफ 2015. ब्रेस्टफीडिंग विद इन वन आवर ऑफ बर्थ इज जस्ट 41%. And exclusive breastfeeding is just 54%. That means half the children in our country are not getting breastfed properly. So what is the reason? So bahut baar jab main ye logon se puchti hu ki what could be the reason for this, people say ki oh, there are so many myths in the community. The mother-in-law does not probably gives cow milk or water or something. But now deliveries are happening in hospitals. More than 89% of deliveries in India are happening in hospitals. And in the hospitals, in the first hour, who is there in the labor room? It is either the gynecologist or the pediatrician, medical officer, nurse, or the staff, right? Then why is the statistic 41%? जब मैंने ये पहली बार देखा तो मुझे लगा कि I should first look within myself. And when I looked within myself, I realized कि 41% का responsibility मेरे अंदर है because normally what happens is when a baby gets delivered, we just take the baby to the warmer for cleaning and vitamin K and footprint and everything, and the baby and the mother get separated, and we get busy in stitching. So when we give the baby to the mother, it's already either 45 minutes or 1 hour over. So this statistics can only change if gynecologists take the lead and become leaders in breastfeeding. So today, my job is to share with you how our community, the community of gynecs, can change the breastfeeding scene in India. And I would want to share ki maine ye book padhi thi, Impact of Birthing Practices on Breastfeeding. So I read this book, I think, in 2016. And the first time I read this book, it just blew my mind because I had never thought that what we do inside the labor room can actually have impact on what happens to breastfeeding. So this is what I read in the book, that labor is a hormonal process. We all know that it depends on oxytocin. So if oxytocin is not coming out properly, we land up into dysfunctional labor. Similarly, if you go along the continuum, breastfeeding is also a hormonal process. If oxytocin is not coming out properly, there is lactation failure. So if in the labor time we are doing things that are anti-oxytocin, that depress oxytocin in the mother, that continues into breastfeeding and impacts breastfeeding as well. So birth practices impact breastfeeding. So how? So which are the birth practices that can impact breastfeeding? Let's start with the first thing. What about the birthing environment? हम लोग ने सब में देखा है कि मेडिकल कॉलेजेस में, डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल्स, government hospitals, maybe not in private, I'm not sure. It's not the most warm or the most cozy environment for a mother to deliver in, because we have often seen scenes like this, ki jaldi deliver karo, tumko samajh nahi aata hai. And so when this happens, what happens to oxytocin? Whenever there is a lot of stress, pain, anxiety, shouting, screaming, or separation from the baby, oxytocin just goes down. Or if we ensure a birth environment, that's something like this. What do you think when you think of this, when you see this one picture? The first word that comes to our mind is touch, is love, warmth, or painless delivery. When we ensure these things, oxytocin just zooms up. So when oxytocin will zoom up during delivery, not only will the delivery happen properly, even the start of breastfeeding will be very smooth. So first birthing practice that is very important is ensuring a warm breastfeeding birthing environment. So you may see it as a joke, but can we have labor room something like this, less medicalized, maybe some agarbattis or warm environment, some thoda sa andhera karke, and the oxytocin really will go up. The second thing is I want to share about the Fortisella recommendations. I don't know whether you have heard about this. In 1985, there was a conference about this, about appropriate technology for birth. And they actually came out with some 5-6 recommendations that can be done inside the labor room to make the labor room more mother friendly. So the first thing was companion of choice. So I'll just take you through the Fortisella recommendations, which I think has somewhere got lost. This document nobody has seen. The choice of a birth companion. Birth companion, maybe a husband, maybe mother, maybe sister, anyone who the mother trusts. This research has proven that continuous support of women during childbirth leads to more vaginal deliveries, shorter labor, reduced pain medication, and even reduced reduced proportion of neonates needing resuscitation. Third is choice of position. Hamare yahan to ek hi position mein deliver hoti hai mothers, that is on the table in the laid back position or lying down position. I think laid back bhi bahut hi kam hota hai, koi propped up bhi nahi karta hai mother ko bahut time to. And do we allow our mothers to walk around? So I have never seen mothers delivering in any other position in the hospitals I have gone to. We just go to one position, and that is even lithotomy is sometimes given. Lithotomy mein hum log mother ke dono pair bhi band dete hain, which is incredibly anxiety provoking for the mother. So if we allow this, research has proven that it can, allowing walking, sitting, standing, kneeling, squatting can decrease the labor duration by 1 hour and decrease the need for analgesia. The fourth labor practice that I can suggest or I can advocate for is pain relief. When I had gone to Malaysia for a breastfeeding course, this is a flyer that I saw in Malaysia's district hospital. This was given to every pregnant mother who comes there. And what was written there? Pain control options during delivery. So they were given all these options, pharmacological, non-pharmacological. And they had to choose one of them. During my delivery, I want this. So when we think of pain control, we only think of epidural analgesia. But there are so many non-pharmacological methods. You can see choice of companion, warm drinks, massage, walking, pressure, acupuncture, acupressure. So many things were there. This is a great method to decrease pain and increase oxytocin. Can we think of something like this in India? Very important separation. I just spoke about how after delivery, baby gets taken by the nurse to the warmer and we are busy with the mother. This happens both in cesarean and in normal delivery. हम लोग को ऐसा लगता है कि शुरुआत में वी आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द मदर and the pediatrician is responsible for the baby, and we come and stand between the mother and the baby. This never happens, for example, in a jungle when there is no gynecologist or pediatrician, and everything just happens naturally. And जैसे कोई गाय का बच्चा हो या हाथी का बच्चा हो, वो आराम से जाके ब्रेस्ट फीड करता है, वहां पे तो कोई लैक्टेशन कंसल्टेंट नहीं आता है. सो व्हाई देयर इज एन इशू इन डिलीवरीज विद ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. सो आई एम हियर टू टॉक अबाउट ब्रेस्ट क्रॉल विद ऑल ऑफ यू. आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव सीन अ वीडियो राइट नाउ. आई डोंट हैव द टाइम टू शो यू द वीडियो, बट आई कैन शेयर द लिंक विद यू आफ्टर द प्रेजेंटेशन. सो ब्रेस्ट क्रॉल में क्या होता है, यू सिंपली पुट द बेबी ऑन द एब्डोमेन आफ्टर डिलीवरी, यू डोंट इवन कट द कॉर्ड. And in any case, we like to practice delayed cord clamping. So baby is just kept there on the abdomen, even cleaned on the abdomen, provided baby has cried after birth and is fine. So after that, in within the next 10 to 15 minutes, baby crawls on the abdomen and goes to one of the breasts and starts to latch. So why do you think this happens? The first reason is, humko aisa lagta hai baby is born very weak and we have to teach him breastfeeding, but baby is born with more than 40 neonatal reflexes. Out of those 40 reflexes, almost 15 reflexes you can see here are activated in breast crawl, because the mother is in the laid back position, they all get activated, whereas in other positions which we normally see, cradle, cross cradle, the activation of these reflexes is very poor. In the laid back position after delivery, when the mother is reclining, gravity acts on the baby. So when the gravity acts on the baby, you can see the tongue due to gravity falls out naturally. When the tongue falls out, the latch is better. Baby is maintained on the mother's body naturally. You don't have to hold the baby. Baby is more free. So this leads to a better latch. When we try to hold the baby's head and the breast and try to latch, it is the start of a superficial latch. There are more advantages of breast crawl, like due to the skin-to-skin contact, there is more oxytocin release and faster milk injection, decreased postpartum bleeding, and less hypothermia because of skin-to-skin contact. Baby gets painted with good bacteria. Crying is a lot lesser. Now, what about breast crawl in cesareans? What do you think about that? Can it happen? In fact, this is the way in which we can do breast crawl in cesareans, in which the gynecologist can continue the cesarean and the baby can lie on the mother's chest. If there is fear of contamination of the operative field, we can have a screen in between, and the operation theater temperature can be made more than 26 degrees Celsius. This is one more image that I have. It is all the more important in cesarean to do this, because cesarean may, mother is predisposed to lactation failure. Why? Because separation is all the more in cesareans. Baby may be in the NICU, mother may be in the ward, and many times baby gets a feed of formula even before he has seen the mother. Second is, mother may be in a lot of pain or may be sedated to hold the baby or to feed the baby. As far as the baby is concerned, there are more breathing difficulties because baby has come out through the abdomen. So we generally suggest first hour on the mother's chest and second hour on the father's chest, because the advantages of skin-to-skin contact are the same whether it's on the mother or the father, right? So these are the things that I have described, right from separation, minimal separation, or choice of a birth companion, allowing the mother to ambulate, and choice of a good position. And if we create a normal birth sequence, maybe like it happens in the animal kingdom, if we get out of the way, then probably the oxytocin will come back up, and not only will the labor be smoother, but also the breastfeeding. Now, when I say let's get out of the way, I don't mean to say that the deliveries should happen like pehle hoti thi, jaise ghar mein delivery hoti thi. Main wo nahi keh rahi hu. Of course, labor rooms, hospital deliveries have decreased maternal mortality tremendously, and we have our role in helping the mother deliver. But बट वी शुड नो वेन वी हैव टू स्टेप इन एंड वेन वी हैव टू गेट आउट. As the moment baby delivers, we have to take care of the baby and the mother. But can that be done with the mother baby together? Do we need to separate them in order to do the episiotomy stitching? Do we need to separate them in order to do the cleaning or the footprint or the vitamin K? Can it be done on the mother's chest itself? So these are the questions we have to ask. So I end my dialogue here by, or sorry, the monologue, I should say, by just saying that breastfeeding, gynecs are extremely crucial to breastfeeding success because the mother is with the gynecologist throughout 9 months, from conception to pregnancy to delivery. The pediatrician comes much later. In fact, the delivery is also done by the gynecologist, and the mother is with the gynecologist for the first 3 days or 7 days after delivery. Right? So the most of the time the gynec is with the mother. Can the gynec do antenatal classes and teach the mother about breastfeeding skills like holding or latching or about colostrum? Can we adopt favorable birthing practices like I just described? Can we do breast crawl, and can we provide more postnatal support? So all of these things can give the best start of breastfeeding to the mother. And of course, pediatricians are there, they will come in, but gynecologists can come in much earlier and help the mother to a great start. So this is all I wanted to share. Thanks a lot for listening to me, and I'm here to take all your questions.